you know what? I could do a giveaway. So since I am coming up on my 5K, I want to do a 5K giveaway. Hey everybody, I'm finally back in my room. I wanted to film outside, but it's just a little too hot for that today. We're getting like a little heat wave, which is kind of weird. So I came inside where the air conditioning is. But anyway, so today's gonna be a fun video because it's gonna be two things. So you've seen the title and the thumbnail and everything. So you know, we are gonna be taking a look at this Barbie extra today, which is Barbie extra number 15. I had to look just now because I completely forgot what number she is. But anyway, this was actually gifted to me by one of my lovely subscribers, and I'm going to be opening her and taking a look at her today. But I have a couple announcements before I get into that. Now, as of the, like right now, as I'm filming this, I am sitting at 4,926 subscribers, which means I am only 74 subscribers away from reaching that 5K milestone. And I'm really excited about that, and I'm very appreciative and like so grateful to all of you. I am going to be doing a 5K celebration video, and I just wanted to let you guys know that that is coming up because I want to include some viewer participation. So first things first, I am going to be doing a giveaway. I'm not going to put like all of the details of the giveaway in this video. I'm going to wait and include them in that video, just because I need to flesh everything out. I've never done a giveaway before, so I'm really excited about it. But I'm going to figure out what all is going to be happening. I did get a second one of Barbie extra number 15. So if you've been watching my subscriber mail videos, you know one of these dolls I got a couple months ago, and then I just got another one last week. So because of that, I figured, you know, I don't need two of them. And, you know, I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do with the other one because it's like, I could customize it. But then I thought about it. It's like, you know what? I could do a giveaway. So since I am coming up on my 5K, I want to do a 5K giveaway. So this is going to be one of the dolls that I am going to include in the giveaway since I have two of them. I'm also going to be giving away one of my Halle Bailey live action Little Mermaid dolls. It's probably going to be this one right here. I'm not sure. I'm going to decide just because I have like five of them now after doing all the reviews and stuff like that. I do plan on customizing one or two of them, but I think I'm going to be giving away this one right here. I have not fully decided all of the giveaway prizes, but I am going to be giving away a couple additional dolls and stuff like that. And I think some of them are just going to be from my personal collection, and they're going to be dolls that I'm just ready to let go. So like I said, I'm not going to put all the details of the giveaway in this video. I'm going to wait until the 5K subscriber video. But if you're interested in winning either of those two dolls or any of the others that I'm going to be giving away, then, you know, you're going to have to watch that video to find out how to enter for that. Now, the other thing, talking about viewer participation, which by the way, I'm going to get to the review here in just a second. But viewer participation, which actually, I'm going to show you the box while I'm talking about it. So this is the box. Like I said, this is number 15. This is the doll that looks like Raquel. And she's the, you know, all silver and purple one. So for viewer participation, I want to do a Q&A because a lot of you have questions for me and you were showing interest in me doing a Q&A. Here's the back of the box so you can see the artwork on the back. But anyway, two things. One, I want to get questions from you. Now, I have collected questions in a couple different ways. I'm going to start opening this while I'm talking. I have collected questions in a couple different ways in the past. I have done Instagram, like where you can type in a question there. I've posted on my community page and just done like a poll where you can add the questions there, which I'll probably do both of those just so that way I have them. But I think the easiest way, since you know it's coming up, go ahead and put, if you have any questions for me that you want me to answer in the Q&A video during that 5K celebration, go ahead and put them down this video. So that way it's just an easy place for me to come and get all of the questions and put them all together. And then that way I can gather them and have them ready for when I'm ready to film. I'm not just doing a normal Q&A video. You know, there you can, if you like, just put your question down in the comment section. However, I want to include you guys, since I'm celebrating you, my subscribers, I thought it would be fun if I included you in that video. Hey everybody, I just wanted to jump in here really quick because the first time I tried to record this section of the video, I got really rambly and repeated myself a lot. So I want to try and make it as like easy and like clear as possible. But basically, if you would like to be part of my 5,000 subscriber celebration video, then all you need to do is record a short video of yourself. And in that video, just tell me your name, where you're from. If you don't want to say your name, you can use like your YouTube or your Instagram handle if you prefer, and then ask me a question or share one of your favorite dolls from your collection, or you know, say something. But all I ask is that you keep the videos to be pretty short, maybe no more than 7 seconds, only because I want to make sure that I can include everybody if they have like any questions for the Q&A section and stuff like that. If you want to submit a video, then please send it to the email address that I'm putting up on the screen right now. That email address is chadmarvelous5k@gmail.com. I'm gonna have that. That's a temporary email, and I want all of the video submissions to go there. I won't be accepting video submissions anywhere else, so please send them all to that email address. The deadline to submit them is going to be this upcoming Friday, which is May 19th, and the deadline is going to be midnight California time, Pacific time. So if you're in a different time zone than I am, then you'll have to figure out what time zone that is for you. But basically, just get it in before the end of the day on Friday and you'll be fine. If you're not sure how to send a video, then you could use a service like Google Photos or Dropbox, where basically you upload your video to that service and then simply send a shareable link to the email address. And then that way I can get access to the videos, download them all, and then I will include them in the editing process. So that way I can get them in the video. Also, if you are under the age of 18, please make sure you have a parent's permission before sending me a video. Anyway, that's gonna be pretty much it. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments down below as far as the video submissions. But for right now, let's go ahead and get back to the review. All right, so enough of all that stuff. Let's take a look at this doll. So this is Barbie Extra number 15. I think earlier I might have called her a fashionista. She's Barbie Extra, not Barbie fashionista. But I love this doll so much. I love the purple, and I like that she has purple lipstick. So really quick, let's take a look at her face, because she is so pretty, and I see why a lot of people were saying that she looks like Raquel from Barbie Life in the Dream House, because she's, you know, similar. I don't think she has the same exact face mold, but I think that it's similar enough to the dolls that came out around that time. She has these cute little hair clips, and they have like a little star on them. They're like, I don't know what these are supposed to be, little pearls with a star, but they're like the vacuumized metal, kind of metallic plastic hair clips. She has beautiful long black saran hair. The saran hair is a little like box hair. There's little dents or kinks in the hair where the rubber bands were holding the hair in the box. That's super easy to fix with a boil wash, or honestly, just washing the hair with like warm water from your tap might be enough to get rid of that. But anyway, so she's got a center part. And, you know, sometimes center parts can be a little off-center. Hers is not bad. I like the amount of hair that it has. Like, it's pretty good rooting. Like, I'm not seeing, like, any bald spots. I always like to point that out because, you know, it matters. She has these really cute earrings. These are, like, these giant door knocker diamond shaped earrings. I'm not a huge fan of big earrings on dolls because their hair usually gets stuck in them, but like I like the way it looks, so that's good. She has this really cute like faux fur jacket. It's all like tinfoil. This metallic PVC material. I don't know what exactly it actually is, but it's kind of like a faux leather or something. It's actually really nice. Like, the details on this are really nice, and it has like a belt attached to it with a belt loop or I like this. So Rainbow High has some like realistic belts where the buckle is, you can slide it and stuff like that, but sometimes it's hard to do. As much as I love functional items on a doll scale, sometimes it's hard to deal with, but in this case it's nice because it's kind of just permanently in that spot, and then instead there is like loops here to like thread it through, but behind there's like a little snap. So if you want this to be closed, you can actually snap it closed, and then, well, I didn't get it in the snap, hold on, there we go, snap it closed, there we go, and see, it'll stay. So it's got a little snap right there. I actually really like that, and I appreciate that, because I have a couple Rainbow High dolls that have jackets with the belt thing, and it got tore up because trying to get it through the little belt loop to actually do this tore up the end of it, and I hate the way it looks now. So I'm glad that Barbie did this. she's got a shirt underneath. Oh, look at that, I didn't even know. That's so cute. Hold on, I want to see what this looks like. Oh, this is cute. It's like a turtleneck long. I didn't even know she had this shirt. I like that with the hearts all over it. It looks like a thin, oh, it's super soft. Oh, I like this material a lot. This is really nice, really soft. I don't think I have another Barbie that has this material. Or if I do, I'm just not remembering. But anyway, so she, oh, and she's even got necklaces that I didn't see. Everything was hidden by her faux fur collar. Those are so cute. I like that. I'm gonna take her jacket off. Let's see what she looks like without the jacket. Is this attached? Oh, there we go. The faux fur was stuck in between her neck and her head. But anyway, okay, so, long sleeve. That's cute, a completely different look. I like that. Oh, I like that a lot, okay. I like that they're giving us multiple layers. I think the reason I thought that it was just the jacket is because I have a Bella from Twilight doll, and she's wearing a jacket, but nothing underneath it. Like, there's no undershirt. I think they just assume it's like a collector doll, so you're only gonna have her in the box or on display, so whatever. But cool, I'm glad that they did that. I like this skirt. The material is, once again, actually quite nice. I'm surprised. It is metallic, it is kind of stretchy. I think this is a polyester material, but then it has like a metallic paint on the one side because the other side is kind of like white. So it's kind of nice. I'm worried that this might crack over time, like, as it gets older, it dries out and kind of gets cracked and like whatever. But I feel like I've seen this style before with the side ruffle for Barbie. I think they've used it before, but like, I'm not complaining about it at all. It's a cute little design. It's an interesting. I think I would have been fine if it didn't have the ruffle and it was just like a mini skirt the way that it is, like, you know, just a solid regular pencil skirt or whatever. I think I might have preferred it a little bit more, but this is Barbie extra, and we know she needed to be extra, trying to go over the top. You're doing way too much, girl, just saying. But anyway, I think that it's cute. Like, I'm not complaining about it by any means. Let's go down to, like, I'm pretty sure, like, my favorite part of her outfit, which is these boots. Can we talk about these boots for a second? Like, these make me, like, if you're doing a custom Barbie version of Monster High characters, these boots could totally be Claudine's boots. Like, I really like that. I don't know why I zoomed out, because now I gotta zoom back in so I can show you these. But anyway, I love these boots with the painted buckles. And like, I don't know, it's the shape of the shoe down here that I like. Because sometimes they can be a little, like, I don't know, there's certain styles that are not my favorite. These ones I really like, and they have like the covers with the boot, with the buckles and stuff. I love these boots. I think these are super, super cute. So, and then of course, because she is a Barbie extra, she has some really good articulation. Not the best, not my favorite articulation, but still, it's fully articulated. So she's got movement at the head. She has movement in both of her shoulders. She has movement in both of her elbows and wrists. She has movement at her hips. And then she does have a bend at the knee. So it's not like fully made to move necessarily, but I love the fact that we're getting a fully articulated doll at least. And I'm really happy because since she's got these high heel boots, she's got the pointed toes. She doesn't have the flat feet that I get annoyed by. Now I've done these kind of out of order because she does come with some accessories and I usually show those first, but let me show you what she comes with. So first of all, she comes with this. I'm assuming this is a phone. It kind of looks like a little phone. It has a question mark on it for some reason, and I do not know why. It's got little cat ears on the top, and then on the back, it's got like a little stand. So, or maybe this is a picture frame. I don't know why she has a picture of a question mark, but I mean, you do you. No, it's got like little raised buttons on the bottom here. So I think this is supposed to be a phone, but I love that it's got like a little stand so it can stand up, and the stand might be able, you know, hold on, let me check and see. This might be able to double as a way for her to hold it. So yeah, I mean, she can hold her phone this way. And it looks like she's looking at her phone or maybe talking to somebody on FaceTime. So like that works. I like that. And the fact that you can do that, but then also like if you have a Barbie play set, like the Dream House or something like that, you can set this on one of the counters and it stands up on its own. So that's cool. She comes with a purse, which is a giant slice of pizza. Like this is the size of the pizza next to her. So yeah, it's a really large slice of pizza. It does not open, but it has a molded zipper here. Let me zoom in so you can see this. Here we go. Molded zipper and, you know, like the pizza toppings and everything. This is super cute. And then it's like got this like studded strap here for her to hold it. I'm thinking that like the theme of her outfit is like takeout because you've got the pizza slice and you've got the tin foil. All we have to do is like fold this up into like a swan or something. And I don't know. That's really funny. Random things that it makes me think about when I see. And then of course she comes with a pet because why wouldn't she? So it is this cute little Dalmatian that has these little heart sunglasses. I don't hate it. I'm just like, I don't need the pets, you know? But she's a really cute little, these are removable, by the way. You can take the sunglasses off and she just looks so happy. Okay, I like this puppy. This is a really cute puppy. I kind of like this. And then the little pink bow, which is removable. So for whatever reason, you don't want her to have the bow. But anyway, there we go. So this is the little pet. And that's pretty much it. She doesn't really come with any other accessories. I think I'm going to wash her hair and then I think I'm gonna put her hair up in a high ponytail because I am a sucker for a doll with a high ponytail. And since her hair is so long, I can do it. I don't know, I'm gonna play around with it and figure out how I wanna display her. But I am really happy to have her. I love her purple makeup. And I think that she is so pretty. Anyway, that's gonna be it for today's video. I'm gonna get going for right now. I do have a few other videos that are coming out this week. So just a reminder, make sure you get those video submissions if you want to be in the 5K celebration video submitted to that email address. Once again, I'm just going to put the email address up on the screen as a reminder for chadmarvelous5k@gmail.com and make sure to have those videos submitted no later than this upcoming Friday, which is Friday, May 19th, 2023. And if you don't want to do a video submission or aren't able to for one reason or another, but you still have a question for me, make sure to leave it down in the comments on this video. But anyway, I'm going to get going for right now. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope I see you next time. Bye! If you like this video, you can let me know by hitting thumbs up. You can check out some of my other videos by clicking one of the links on the screen. I post new videos every week, so be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified every time I upload. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video.